Hey everyone, welcome to the ninth and final video in the series in which we examine the lifecycle of writing and deploying a Chialisp smart coin. In the last video, we deployed our piggy bank to the network and were able to identify it using an RPC call. In this video, we're going to actually be contributing some money to the piggy bank that we've created in order to reach our savings goal. For the purpose of time, I'm not going to show you an intermediate transaction. I'm just going to show you the case in which we reach our savings goal so that we can actually watch the money come back to our wallet. Feel free to try out other spends on your own. Before we get started here, I want to go ahead and show you a couple of files that I've added to our project since the last video. I went ahead and added this contribution.clsp file. The reason that I added this file is because in a real environment, we would like to be able to contribute to these piggy banks using our standard Chia wallet. Unfortunately, spending the standard transaction is a little bit out of the scope of this tutorial. So instead, what we're going to do is we're going to send to this puzzle, and then this puzzle is going to be able to contribute to the piggy bank coin. Let me give you a brief rundown of how this puzzle works. We curry in a pub key, and then we use that pub key to assert that there is a signature on the other two values. We do this so that these two values are secure and no farmer or full node can change these without the spend failing. The only other thing that we do is we assert the announcement from the piggy bank, which remember is the hash of the coin ID of the piggy bank coin and the message that it's announcing, which in this case happens to be new amount. Notice that the one thing that this puzzle does not do is create a new coin. This is what we want. We want all of the value from this coin to be lit on fire so that the piggy bank coin can absorb it as extra value so that it can create a coin of a higher value. I've also added this file here called signedContribution.py. What this does is basically acts as driver code for our contribution coin. I've put it in the form of a script so that when we need the signature as we're constructing our spend bundle, we can go ahead and get it in real time. Let's go ahead and construct our spend bundle now. I'm going to go ahead and construct the spend bundle as a JSON file. So let me go ahead and create that right now. All right, so we have our spendbundle.json file, and now let's go ahead and fill it out with the skeleton of the spend bundle that we're going to be creating. I'm going to go ahead and define the two keys that are on the spend bundle. The first is coin spends, and this is going to be a list of all the coins we're spending and how to spend it. The only other key on the top level of the spend bundle is aggregated signature. And this, of course, is the complete aggregated signature of all of the signatures that are necessary to complete all of the spends in the bundle. Let's go ahead and start defining coin spends here. A coin spend has three keys. The first is the coin that you're spending. The second is the puzzle reveal. And the third is the solution. I need to delete this comma. And this needs to be a string. Okay. And finally, we're going to go ahead and fill out the skeleton of the coin. By now, you should know that a coin is made up of a parent coin info or ID, a puzzle hash, and an amount, which we will leave as zero for now. Now, when we are doing the spend, we are actually going to be spending two coins. We're going to be spending the piggy bank coin and also the contribution coin. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this, put a comma, and paste it. This is going to be the basic skeleton for our spend bundle. Let's go ahead and start filling it out. Let's do the piggy bank spend first. If you remember from the last video, we used the RPC to get a coin record for our piggy bank coin. Let's go ahead and do it again now. CDV RPC coin records by puzzhash. I still have this saved from the last video. And after a moment here, you'll see we have a coin record for our piggy bank coin. We see it has amount zero. And what we really needed here was this parent coin info. We're gonna head back to our spend bundle, fill this in. We already had the other two pieces of information, but we might as well copy them since we're here. And the amount is still zero. Now the puzzle reveal. You may be tempted to get the puzzle reveal from this X file. But remember, when we hash the puzzle, we hash it with the curried arguments. The puzzle reveal needs to be this basic puzzle, but it also needs to include the arguments that we curried in when we created the coin. Let's go ahead and recurry our piggy bank and get that compiled puzzle. If we go CDV CLSP curry and we specify our piggy bank coin, remember that the target amount we were using was 500 mojos. And the cash out puzzle hash was a puzzle hash from my wallet, which I still have saved here as a wallet puzzle hash. Make sure to put a 0x in front of everything that you want to be interpreted as bytes. I'm going to go ahead and hit enter. And this is the compiled CLVM, but what we need is we need the bytecode. So I'm going to add one more flag here, dash x. And that's going to get us the bytecode that we need to paste into the puzzle reveal key. Let me just go ahead and paste that. Lastly, we need the solution. Normally, we're not building spend bundles by filling in JSON manually. Normally, we're doing this as part of some sort of Python script, and it will handle this by calling our driver code. But since we're doing this via JSON, let's just go ahead and make this solution on our own. We obviously don't know how to write serialized CLVM, but what we can do is we can use the handy opc command to take any CLVM that we write and turn it into serialized CLVM. For our solution for this coin, if you remember, we need three things. We need my amount, the amount of the coin that we're spending, which in this case is zero. We need new amount, which we're going to contribute 1,000 mojos. And we need my puzzle hash, which is the puzzle hash of the coin that we're spending. Two of these we've already retrieved and we have in our spend bundle already. We just need to add 1,000 in here. So let's go ahead and my amount is zero. New amount is going to be 1,000. And the puzzle hash, if we go to our spend bundle here, is this. And remember 0x if you want it to be interpreted as bytes. We run this and we get our serialized solution, and we can just copy this and paste it right here. That is our first spend out of the way. Next, let's go ahead and do the contribution spend. I have already created this coin on the network as well, and I've saved its puzzle hash so that we can retrieve it via the RPC just like we did with the other one. CDV RPC coin records by puzzle hash, and then we specify our contribution puzzle hash. This is the coin that I pushed to the blockchain. I'm going to go ahead and grab the information here and start filling it in. We have our parent coin info, we have our puzzle hash, and our amount this time is 1,000. The puzzle reveal. Remember that this puzzle had one argument curried in, and it's the pub key. So let's go ahead and curry this puzzle as well. CDV, CLSP, curry, piggy bank, contribution, and let's specify the pub key, which again I have saved already. Remember, 0x for bytes. We compile it, but we needed the dash x flag in order to get the bytecode. And we can just copy this and paste it into our spend bundle. The final thing we need here is our solution. Let's go ahead and make that now. I'll go ahead and clear again and use opc. Our solution here takes two values, the coin ID of the piggy bank coin and new amount. We know that new amount is going to be 1,000, but what is the ID of the piggy bank coin? Well, one way that we can find this out is by our RPC again. So let me delete this. We'll use CDV RPC coin records by puzzle hash. And then if we specify our piggy bank's puzzle hash again, this time we'll add one extra flag, dash name dict. And that's going to give us the same exact result, but it's going to give us in a dictionary with the ID as the key. Another way you could have done this is by manually hashing together the parent coin info concatenated with the puzzle hash, concatenated with the amount, in CLVM that looks like SHA-256, parent ID, puzzle hash, amount. For right now, I have it from the RPC though, so I'm just gonna have it copied. We're gonna go back to our opc here, and we're gonna paste it in again as bytes, and our new amount is 1,000. So let's go ahead and run this and we get our serialized solution. We've almost entirely filled out our spend bundle here, but we need one last thing, and that's the aggregated signature. Remember, I created a driver code for this. So I'm just gonna go ahead and run this now, but I do need to fill in the coin ID of the piggy bank coin. Let me grab that again. Just gonna fill it in here and we'll run it with Python. And this is going to be our aggregated signature. If you don't have any signatures in your spend bundle, you can't just leave it as an empty string. It needs to be an empty signature, which looks like this. It's C with 191 zeros after it. Let me go ahead and just close out of that. And we're going to go ahead and paste our aggregated signature here. And that should be a completed spend bundle. Now that we have this completely filled out, we should just be able to push it to the network. How are we going to do that? We're going to do it using the RPC again. If we look at the help for our RPC subcommand, we'll see that one of the commands is push TX, and this is the endpoint we're going to be using. That's clear. CDV RPC push TX, and we're just going to specify our spend bundle file. You can pass anything in here. You can pass in the bytes of the spend. You can pass it in the string version of the JSON, but we're just going to go ahead and pass it in as the file. And if we run this, it gives us status success, and success is true. All right, so we've pushed the spend bundle. It has now gone through and been confirmed on the blockchain. So what we're going to do is we're going to first search for the puzzle hash of our piggy bank coin, CDV RPC coin records by puzzhash. Oops, forgot to specify the puzzhash. And as you can see, we now have two coin records in here. The first is the spent version of the coin record. This is the one that we used to construct our spend bundle. And now we have a new one, which is spent equals false. And it's our piggy bank again with the parent coin info that was our coin ID for the last one. And it's amount zero. We have recreated our piggy bank successfully. And all of the excess value should have gone to our wallet. If we go ahead and grab the coin records for that puzzle hash, CDV RPC coin records by puzzhash, we should see here we've been paid 1,000 mojos, which is what we contributed, and we have it available to spend. So that's it. That is the entire process of making and spending a coin. Again, a lot of this is going to be done by a Python driver code or whatever language driver code, but it's a good idea to just get in here and mess around with the actual fields of a spend sometimes so that you know exactly what's going on whenever you're spending a coin. That's going to be it for this video series. If you've had any trouble following along at all, if you've had any trouble setting up any of your environment, if you've had any questions that have come up that I have failed to cover, please head over to our Chialisp channel on Keybase, and we should be able to help you out there.